my name is Pastor David Bauer. I'd like to welcome you to another segment of Bethel's Bread. Today we're going to be in the book of Matthew. We're going to be in chapter 6, verses 5 and 6. The Bible teaches us, "And when thou prayest, thou shalt not be as the hypocrites are. For they love to pray, standing in the synagogues and in the corners of the streets, that they may be seen of men. Verily I say unto you, they have their reward. But thou, when thou prayest, enter into thy closet, and when thou hast shut thy door, pray to thy Father which is in secret, and thy Father which seeth in secret shall reward thee openly." One of the least used tools of the Christian life today is prayer. Just talking to God. You know, God says we can talk to him all the time, pray without ceasing, come boldly to the throne of grace. We are allowed and in fact encouraged in the scripture to talk to the Father every minute of every day. We're supposed to pray to him a lot. I have seen in the past many folks that they like the proverbial back pat. They like the folks to notice what they are doing. And I understand some of that. Everybody wants to be accepted. But at the very end of the day, truthfully, we should want to be accepted by him. Thy labor is not in vain in the Lord, and we should want to do things for him. Prayer's no different. God wants to talk to you. I think the most business that's ever done in the realm of prayer is when you pray to God all by yourself. You're not looking for people to hear you. You're not looking for anybody to notice. You're looking to just pray to God. One of the greatest times of prayer I ever have is when I'm by myself. The Bible talks about it being a prayer closet. If you think about a prayer closet, I don't suggest you have to have a closet, although I know some folks that do have closets and they work very, very well for a place of prayer. But I want you to think about just for a moment, a place that you can get alone, a place that you can solitarily call on your God and let him know what you're feeling. He knows your heart, but boy, he sure does like to hear from you. I know that when God hears from his children, he's so very thrilled. I love my kids and I love to hear from them. And matter of fact, I don't like it when I don't hear from them. I worry that perhaps something is wrong with their lives and things of that nature. And I'm a man. He's God. He knows what's going on in here, but he still wants to hear from us. What a great God. I challenge you today, find yourself a place. Find yourself a place to pray. Good to have a schedule in your life and a time to pray as well. But praying alone is one of the greatest things in the whole wide world you can do. He can give you a peace that only he can understand. We can understand it. He gives us a comfort that he's the God of all comfort, the Bible says. And I hope and pray that you seek some in the realm of prayer. It's not that difficult. It's a wonderful, wonderful thing. And I sure do hope that you can find yourself a place just to talk to God. It doesn't have to be anything formal. What it has to be is a meeting between you and the Almighty God. He wants to hear from you. He loves you desperately. And I hope and pray that you find yourself a place to pray. I'm Pastor David Ballard. This has been another segment of Bethel's Bread. I sure do hope you have a great day.